Hello and welcome to Vaning Online Smart Class. I'm Raja, the faculty of English, and this video is based on inversion case, which is very important topic for your competitive exam. First, let's understand what is inversion case and how it is different from a general or from a normal sentence structure. If people know us, in a normal sentence, first we write subject, then we use verb. But in inversion, first we have to use verb, then we write subject. So, inversion plays an important role in your grammar. Now, I have written two sentences. You have to read it and answer me which one is correct. Under the table is sleeping a cat. Second sentence, under the table a cat is sleeping. If I ask which one is correct, definitely most of you will answer that second one is correct because it sounds good and the first one does not sound. But remember, here I have used inversion case. So, this one is correct, under the table is sleeping a cat. Why? Because at the beginning of a sentence, an adverbial place or place adverb is used. So, remember, whenever a sentence starts with a place adverb, that time we use inversion case. We will learn it just few minutes after, but now we have to understand on which condition, on what condition we use inversion case. Remember, first condition for inversion case, that is, sentence should start with a negative adverb or negative adverbial phrases. What are the negative adverbs? Seldom, hardly, rarely, scarcely, barely, notional. Whenever a sentence starts with this type of adverb, remember, we have to use inversion. You cannot say, seldom he calls me. This is a wrong. You have to write or you have to say, seldom does he call me. You do not say, no sooner he saw his father than he started reading. Rather say, no sooner did he see his father than he started reading. Why? Because in inversion, first we have to write auxiliary, then subject, then verb. Got my point? In inversion, what we have to use? First we have to write auxiliary, then subject, then verb. Clear? So, seldom, hardly, scarcely, rarely, barely, notional. Along with these phrases like under no circumstances, in no way, on no condition, no account, at no time. If any sentence starts with these phrases, you should use inversion case. If I say under no circumstances he will help you, it's wrong. It should be under no circumstances will he help you. Clear? Now come to the second condition. In second condition, what? We have to use inversion whenever a sentence starts with an adverbial place or place adverb, like here, there, up, down, in front of the gate, at the top of the hill. Or round the corner, under the tree, under the table, whatsoever. Whenever any sentence starts with adverbial places, you have to use inversion case. You are quite acquainted with certain sentences like here comes Raju, or you can say there is a boy. Here and there is adverb, but Raju and boy is the subject. So comes and is at the verb. So, you always write, there is a boy. Do you write, there a boy, this is wrong, this one is correct. Clear? Now, move to next condition. On what condition we use inversion? That means, you have to use inversion case when a sentence starts with only plus adverb or any kind of adverbial phrases. If I write or if I say only yesterday, only tomorrow, only today, only now, with if you find this type of phrases, definitely you have to use an inversion case. Along with if you find only by doing this, only by approaching this, if you find this type of phrases, then also inversion takes place. Here, I have written an example, only by working hard did Santosh get success. Only by working hard did Santosh get success. I did not write Santosh got success. Santosh got would be wrong. So I wrote here only by working hard did Santosh get success. Only last month did she die. It is correct. Never ever write only last month she died. It's wrong. Clear? So inversion case takes place when a sentence starts with only plus adverb or adverb replaces. Now move to the next condition. Well, the next condition, when a sentence starts with so plus of adverb manner, that time we use inversion case. Mark this example. So well did he organize the function that everyone started praising him. Here I did not write so well he organized. Because if I write so well he organized, then inversion case didn't happen. So to make inversion case, I have to mention so well did he organize. Clear? Now move to our next point. In the next point, I mentioned you that inversion case takes place with the phrases like to such a degree, to such an extent, to such a point, to such a length. If a sentence starts with these phrases, we have to use inversion case. Mark this example. To such an extent, he made the investment that people started trusting him. This is here I made a mistake. Like he made the investment. Rather, it should be to such an extent. Did he make the investment? Got it? To make it inversion, we have to mention to such an extent did he make the investment that people started trusting him. Hope this short video of inversion case will help you a lot in your competitive exam. If you are satisfied with this video, or if you want that you should get this type of videos for your competitive exams, by watching this you can score good marks, then join Vanik online smart classes. Thank you.